Today, we're going to be talking about if you let your ex go, will they come back? And if you stick around to the very end of this video, I'm going to show you some of the internal research that me and my team have done that kind of points an interesting light on this question. But first, if you have not already, make sure you stop everything you're doing and visit our website to take our ex recovery chances quiz. On our website, exboyfriendrecovery.com, we've put together a quiz that will tell you what kind of chance you have of getting your ex back. The quiz is really easy to take. It only takes you about 2 minutes, and all you have to do is fill out the questions that are prompted, and we give you an idea on sort of where you stand with your ex so that you know you're not wasting your time or you know you need to potentially start moving on. So if you're interested in taking that quiz, it's really easy. All you have to do is simply look in the description link below this YouTube video and click on it. See? Super easy. All right, now let's talk about if your ex will come back if you let them go. If you love something so much, let it go. If it comes back, it was meant to be. If it doesn't, it never was. That is perhaps one of the most famous quotes regarding love. Letting it go, and if it comes back, it was always yours to begin with. But does reality work out the same way? Well, yes and no. I know that's not exactly the answer you want to hear, but allow me to expand. Simply leaving and ignoring your ex, or using a strategy that ignores your ex, will not be enough to get your ex to come back to you alone. You need something more. You need an overall arching game plan or strategy. But there is one really interesting thing that me and my team have noticed over the years. And before I tell you what that interesting thing is, let's first talk about the overall game plan you should be implementing when you want to try to get your ex back. Now, I am one of the biggest proponents for the no contact rule. Ignoring your ex at its core seems to be one of the most prolific strategies that most experts like me are recommending. But where I am maybe different from some of my other peers is that I don't think it's smart to rely on the no contact rule alone. Think of it like this. If the no contact rule is one simple piece of the puzzle, you're not going to have a full picture. Your puzzle is going to be incomplete. There's more little puzzle pieces that you need to fit together to make this process work for you. And for the better part of this past decade, my team and I have been working to figure out what the best pieces to sort of pair with the no contact rule are. And we've determined that there are really two pieces to this equation, the value chain and the value ladder. Let's start with the value ladder first. So what is the value ladder? Well, simply put, it's the types of communications that you should be having with your ex after a no contact rule. Now, if you want to get really technical, there are 5 types of communications that you should be having with your ex. But today we're only talking about 3 because they're the most common types. You have text messaging, which is simply you texting your ex on your phone. You have phone calls, video calls, Skype, things of that nature. And you have one-on-one interaction. These are the most common ways in which you should be communicating with your ex after a breakup. Now, if you're confused as to how you should stack each one on each other, that's probably something that you need to learn on your own by visiting our website, www.exboyfriendrecovery.com. But we still haven't covered every single strategy that we're talking about here. So we've talked about the value ladder. What about the value chain? So where the value ladder was all about the types or methods of communication with your ex, the value chain is all about the conversations you're going to be having with your ex, or rather the type of conversations. We found that there are basically 5 types of conversations that you should be having with your ex throughout the entire process of attempting to get them back. We have small talk, we have telling stories, we have sharing opinions, virgin ground, and sharing feelings. Now, the most common mistake most clients make when I'm working with them is they try to view it as a literal ladder or literal chain that they're trying to climb up. They have one type of conversation and then another type of conversation and another one. Rather, the better way to approach this is to spread all five conversations out throughout the entirety of your attempt to get your ex back. But here is where we found something overly fascinating. Even if you're doing everything right, even if you're using the value ladder, you're using the right types of conversations with your ex, things can still go wrong. Anyone who sits here and tells you that getting an ex back is easy is lying to you. Quite frankly, the odds are almost always stacked against you. And by using our method, you can increase your odds, but increasing your odds don't necessarily guarantee success. In fact, I would still say the odds are relatively stacked against you. So what does this mean? Does it mean you should simply give up on trying to get your ex back if that's what you really want? Well, not necessarily, but what I think it ultimately means is that even if you do everything by the book, even if you're perfect, things can still not work out. And here is where my team and I have found something very fascinating. You see, we've been blessed over the years with many different success stories, and what potentially separates us from our other peers is that we're not afraid to dive deep and talk to these success stories to figure out what really worked for them. We always get all sorts of different types of answers, but interestingly enough, in a certain subsection of our success stories, of the people that we've interviewed who have gotten their exes back, a pattern has emerged. They've followed our advice, yes, they've done the value ladder, they've done the value chain, everything seemed to be going well, and still things didn't work out. And it was only at the point that they literally said to themselves, and even sometimes to our private Facebook group, "I give up. I'm ready to move on. I can't take this anymore," that they started to see progress. Now, over the years, my team and I have come up with a really interesting term to describe this type of phenomenon. We call it moving on without moving on. Essentially, it's where someone gets to the low point, they get to the breaking point, they bottom out and give up, and then they start to see success with their ex. Their ex all of a sudden wants them again. They notice he's contacting more, she's contacting more. What is going on? Why does this happen? Well, we haven't quite figured that out yet, but here's my hypothesis. I think it ultimately boils down to the fact that people who are literally going to give up can't fake it anymore. Here's my point. Sometimes when I explain this phenomenon to some of my clients, they try to fake it until they can make it. What do I mean by that? Well, they try to say they're going to give up, but deep down in their heart, they still really want their ex back more than anything. It's only the people who literally want to give up, who create this aura around themselves that, you know what, I'm ready to move on, that maybe reattracts an ex. I think it also harkens back to that quote that I recited at the beginning of the video. If you love something so much, let it go. If it comes back, it was meant to be. If it doesn't, it never was. Hey, thank you so much for getting to the end of this video. If you haven't already, make sure you're stopping everything that you're doing and checking out our Ex Recovery Chances quiz. It's a simple 2-minute quiz designed to tell you what kind of chance you have of getting your ex back. And taking the quiz, like I said at the beginning of the video, is super easy. Just simply look in the description link below this YouTube video and click on it. It is that easy. Also, if you haven't already, if you could please like and subscribe to this channel, I'd be eternally grateful. I'll see you next time.